So let me measure this.
Yes.
Okay, good. So we're in the right spot. Okay. Do raise your voice if you can.
Okay.
And then I'm going to ask you a few questions about your book, your life. Mm-hmm. Why are you inspiring to write this book?
I want to talk specifically about homesick.
And
just about this book or generally speaking?
Generally speaking, mm-hmm. homesick, but why you became a author? Mm-hmm. Why you choose to become a author?
Okay.
So so that's how it is. So you're ready?
Yeah, I'm totally ready.
Okay. So, do I address you as Mr. Eshkol, Nevo, or Dr. Eshkol?
Mr. Eshkol.
Eshkol. Eshkol Nevo.
Yes.
Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
You ready? I'm ready too.
Okay.
So you look at the camera. Okay. After I've done the introduction, we'll just turn and just
talk to the camera or to you?
Okay, both ways.
Okay.
Okay. So, but do raise your voice so that the sound can capture.
Okay.
One. Two and three. Hi, welcome to the National Prince Twice Online News. I'm Mr. Stienberg and welcome to the Stienberg Review. Today we have a special guest with me all the way from Israel, and he's none other than Mr. Eshkol Nevo, who is a well-known author and a new voice in Israel, where he published his book called Homesick. And also, he also written a book called World Cup Wishes and Newland, and they have been translated into English and have won acclaim with audiences around the world, including Israel. Today, we're going to speak more about his life and why he chose to write his books, of course, as part of his passion. Mr. Eshkol, thank you for joining us here at the National Prince Choice.
Thank you for inviting me.
Yes, and you know, it's a great wonder. Everybody wants to know, how do you get your inspiration to write as an author?
Inspiration can come many different ways. You can have a conversation with an interesting person. He can tell you a personal story, and suddenly you have an association that leads you to write. You can see, you can hear a radio program, and a song will capture your soul and bring you back to childhood, and suddenly you want to write. So it really differs from story to story. This specific book, honestly, started with an article. I wanted to write to a newspaper about my childhood. I moved a lot as a child. I've been living in about 12 or 13 different houses as a child, including the United States. And I thought about writing an article about what it is to feel at home, where you really feel at home. From the article emerges the fiction, the novel.
Now, speaking about homesick, you know, how do you define home to you?
Well, it changed through the years. Once I had a real problem in defining what is my home, because we moved so many times, I couldn't tell. I couldn't find people who tell me, imagine a home. I couldn't choose. Now, since I have my first daughter born, I have three already. But since my first daughter was born, it was quite clear that my home is where my daughters are. Now I'm here in Singapore and I'm coming home tomorrow, and I'm coming to home to my daughter. So now it's quite clear, it became very clear. When I wrote the book though, I was still questioning. I still had this question.
Now as a Jew, you know, what is the meaning of diaspora to you? You know, what does it take for a Jew from Israel to embrace the diaspora? Because Homesick is a wonderful book. You know, it describes clearly the way you have experienced life moving from one place to another. Yes.
Yesterday, I was spending the evening with a group of Israel, Jewish Israelis, living in Singapore, working and living in Singapore for a long time. Now, in my generation, this is a legitimate choice. I have no problem with embracing the diaspora, because I think a Jew or an Israeli can live wherever you want. If it feels better in Singapore, it's okay. I choose to live in Israel for many reasons. One of them is the language. I speak Hebrew. I was born and raised by a Hebrew-speaking mother. I write Hebrew. I couldn't live in English. So this is my choice, but it's a legitimate choice to live in another place. the world has changed, it's been globalized. Home has become a more fluid concept, and I totally accept. I know where my home is, but I totally accept other people choosing other choices.
Now, what's next for you? You've written a few novels right now, you know, and for the next project, give us some insight.
You know what's nice about being interviewed abroad? You know, in Israel, I would never tell. it's a big secret. Actually, I'm writing an alphabet, which is about a building with three floors. And every floor is also is a concrete floor, but also representative of floors of the soul, like Sigmund Freud was mentioning. So it's a combination of looking at neighbors, neighborship, neighborhood, and also about psychology. So I would never tell it. But that's a fun thing.
Now, while you were writing that novel, Homesick Yourself, you know, tell us about which part of the book or the chapter of Homesick that brings you more memories and the real reflection of your life. And do you have any regrets?
It's two different questions. Do I have regrets, I think? Everyone has regrets. I definitely can recall moments of my life that I could have chosen the other way. So definitely do have regrets. But you're also asking about a specific moment in the book that I feel close to.
Yes, that's right.
I think at the moment, you know, because I'm just about to fly, to take a taxi to the airport and fly home, I feel closest to the Israeli backpacker. He's traveling in South America and writing letters home to Israel. And the last words of this book, the ending sentence of this book is, and besides, I want to go home. That's the moment I'm in.
And you know, Mr. Nevo, you know, tell us about today's people of Israel. You know, what kind of future do you foresee in the next 5 years? Do you see more people being very more creative and innovative in writing and inventing new things? Because Israel, you know, has been well known for technology, for cuisine and books. You know, it seems to me that it truly lives up to its name, the people of the book. So tell us, what do you see in the next 5 years?
You know, something interesting about Singapore, I noticed only, you know, only 5 days here. But I noticed everybody's talking about the future all the time. Future oriented. I think that's beautiful.
Is that good?
It's very good because Israel is past oriented all the time. We are dwelling in our past. So one thing I wish to my country is being more future focused. And I think technology is good enough, art is good enough, but we need peace. We need a reconciliation with ourselves and with our neighbors. And this is my wish for the future. Our country is very, as we speak, there's a mini violence happening on the border of my country. And you know, and when we have this situation, your biggest wish is that people will stop. Stop that, stop hurting each other. That's the, I think technology is okay. People are writing beautiful books in Israel. You have a lot of readers. We need peace. We need to reconcile.
Now, how can Asia learn from Israel and how to become more innovative?
More innovative.
Yes. You know, especially in writings and
it's a question. It's a question, actually. I'm thinking about it. There's a lot of Singapore people, writers told me, you know, you don't succeed out of Singapore. Why is that happening? Why do you think? How can we? I've been hearing this question. Actually, I'm still thinking about a good answer. But and I've been hearing wonderful Singapore writers, Felix John, for instance, was with me at one of the panels, and he read a beautiful story. So maybe I just an assumption. Maybe it's a matter of also. Market that you lack good writers. Maybe you lack a tradition of writers, because this is a new country, and the Jewish people has like this long heritage of writing. Maybe it's like a tradition, and there are wonderful writers here, and you have to market them better to the world. But I must say, I don't know. I don't know.
Now, how did you...
I don't have a golden advice.
So, yeah, so how did you got your work being noticed worldwide? Was it by accident, or...?
Well, it did well in Israel. Then it attracted attention from Europe, and my agent worked for that, and then it went overseas to the United States. It was a process.
So,
and it wasn't the first novel. Not the first book. It took me just the third book went overseas. Once you make the breakthrough in any field, in media, in economics, in every field, the breakthrough is the hardest.
Yes.
The first cut.
Now, what is culture?
What is culture?
Yes. What is culture?
For me?
Yes. Because Israel
you know
has...
What? Maybe that's connected to your previous question.
I think
culture is a moment when people or a human being is taking a moment out of the daily race of achievement and of economics and of practical thinking and reflecting. He can be reflecting or he can watch watch a show or a movie and it will cause him to reflect. But anyway, it's taking a break. It's taking a break out of this daily river or race that we all are racing, including me. So for me, art is a moment of reflection.
So, culture takes time to develop, I suppose.
It takes time to develop, and it takes patience, I think, from society towards artists, because you can't see an immediate result. It doesn't show immediately like a firm or like an economic venture or a new business. This time, I teach creative writing. From the first lesson, I meet my students. Till the day they publish a book, it's at least 5 or 6 years. I just got a text message from one of my best students. She is now having a big contract in Germany for her book, but it took her 6 or 7 years to get there. So it's patience. It's not. It's fluid and it takes time. Do you think the Singaporean society has this patience?
That's a question we should ask to the writers. But you know what? What advice would you give? Three key advice would you give for writers?
For a new writer.
Yeah, for a new writer.
First of all, patience. As I said, you have to be patient not only in your waiting for your success, but only when you build a scene. If I move on here, I have to portray Singapore for my readers who haven't been in Singapore. I will take the time. And take a lot of details, put a lot of details in it to create the sense and the smell. What does Singapore feel like for someone who has been there again? So patience is one. Don't be afraid to be, think different, to take a new angle that no one has yet taken. Sometimes, most of the time, it's frightening to be different, think different. The opposite of the majority. And I think art is also about that. And be serious. Art is not a thing for people who are just into this to pass time. It's a serious thing. To write a novel, it's a huge project. Put whatever effort into the project. Put your soul into it, and it will be worthwhile.
Mr. Eshkol, Nevo, would you be able to give us just one lifetime quote that you live by, which your parents
quote?
Yeah, which your parents may have passed on to you.
I tell you something that will surprise you. I understand that a lot of many people here are Taoist or connected to Taoism. It's one of the most important lessons in life I learned was through meeting Taoistic readings, because one of the things for me, Taoism is a very complicated and very much more than I imagined now that I've been here. But one thing that I learn from Tao is that sometimes life has its own force, and it will take you. It happens the same in writing. Sometimes you're stuck, don't want to go, where to go with the book, you write a little bit, and the solution is there. The story will take you to the right place. So it's funny to give a Taoistic lesson to you, but actually that's what the first thing that came to my mind.
Well, Mr. Eshkol Nevo, thank you for joining us here at the National Goods Choice. And thank you for joining me, Robin Stienberg, with Mr. Eshkol Nevo, who is one of the well-known authors in Israel, and a bright one as well. Once again, do join me again on the National Goods Choice Online News. I'm Robin Stienberg, and don't forget, have a good week ahead. Thank you. Shalom.
Thank you.
Wait, we can take pictures with these two.
Okay.
And then I can send an email.